Hi guys, I'm discussing multiple choice questions for UPSC. Let us start the session in a couple of minutes. And let everybody join and then we will start the session. So yeah, shall we begin? So yeah, first question: Buddhism and Jainism became very popular in 6th century BC. Which of the following are not the reasons for it? They opposed Varna and Jati system of Hindu religion. They both preached radical non-violence that appealed to the masses. And political unity of India and patronage of Mauryan kings. I mean, which of the following are not the reasons for it? Yeah, C is the answer. Not radical non-violence. Buddhism was not radical. Jainism was radical. Next question. The Congress ministries resigned everywhere in 1939 in response to India's participation in Second World War. The primary argument was A. India had been denied home rule and self-governance for long. India could not associate herself in war, said to be for democratic freedom when a very freedom was denied to her. Indian consent had not been taken before entering the war, and India did not see Germany and Axis powers as enemy nations. Which of the following statements is correct? I mean, which of these is the primary argument because of which Indians did not participate in the war in World War II? Okay, anybody else? See, let us take time, no issues. Go through the question very properly. See through the argument perfectly. See every option. Don't just decide on options. For every answer I'll give, see, we almost get 3 minutes per question. 2 minutes per question. We will do that the same thing here. We'll take 1 minute for answer, 1 minute for question. So don't worry. The answer is B. That is, Indians or Congress could not associate herself in a war which was said to be democratic freedom war, where India herself was denied freedom. See, when World War II broke out in 1939, Viceroy declared that India is a member of the war. Basically, Congress was very, very angry because it was not taken into confidence. Congress's stand was very straight that India could not associate herself in a war which is said to be for democratic freedom. But the very freedom of democratic freedom which the war is propagating is being denied to India. Congress in fact demanded that India should be declared an independent nation. In opposition to this only, Congress ministries resigned in 1940. I mean, Congress had formed government in 1937 elections. 1937, India had elections. Hi, Ria. Congress had formed actually governments in 1937. Using 1937 elections, Congress was able to create ministries even at provinces. But unfortunately, without Congress's permission, I mean, without informing Congress or without even considering how Indians will react, India was made member of the war. And India's argument was not that its permission was not taken. The argument was India was being made a member to a war which is considered to be a war for the sake of democracy. But the funny part is the same democracy is being denied to India. Jinnah supported this. Jinnah really supported this because Congress quit and India, the pressure on government was extremely high. In the context of 1940 Lahore session of the Muslim League, which of the following are true? It passed the Pakistan resolution for creating a separate state for Muslims. It rejected the federal scheme proposed by Government of India Act 1935. Only one, only two, both one and two, none of the above. Yes, yes, I'll let this class finish. I have a plan for you guys. I'll be giving chapters daily, and you come back with that chapter. We'll have a discussion. Not on the chapter, but we'll have an MCQ based approach. C 1 and 2. 1940 Lahore session of Muslim League passed the Pakistan resolution. Who was the guy who submitted Pakistan resolution? Do you have an idea who submitted Pakistan resolution? Yes, Chaudhry Rahmat Ali Khan was the member of Muslim League who submitted the Pakistan resolution. Who asked for Pakistan resolution? Yes. The federal scheme of Government of India Act 1935 was rejected by Muslim League. It was also rejected by Congress. Both Indian National Congress and Muslim League together rejected this federal scheme. Yeah, this 1935 Federation of India. Both of them rejected this. Muslim League as well as Congress. We'll see the next question. Consider the following statements about Buddha. Buddha neither accepts nor rejects the existence of God. Buddha concerned himself with the practical problems concerning man in life. Buddha laid specific emphasis on the law of karma. Which of the following statements are true? Two only, one only, one and two only, all of the above, one, two, three. The answer is D. Buddha did not involve himself in the fruitless controversies about things like God, soul, karma, rebirth. I mean, say Buddha was what in English we call agnostic. He neither accepted the existence of God, neither did Buddha reject the existence of God. He argued that condition of the man in this life depends on his own deeds. So Buddha also accepted the emphasis on law of karma. Yada karma tada sthiti was emphasized by Buddha. Yes, he taught that soul does not exist, and that however he emphasized on ahimsa. For Buddha, the religion was identical with morality, and it emphasized on purity of thought, word and deed. Buddha was a rationalist, and he tried to explain things in the light of reason. I mean, anything which happens in your life, according to Buddha, so does happen because of a purpose. Therefore, we can actually say that's the reason why Buddhism is more or less considered as a social revolution or social change rather than a political or religious reform. Buddhism is actually considered a social reform. It kind of is a book of practical ethics. I mean, where it laid basically very strong basis on the principle of social equality and ethics. Okay, yeah, Buddha was more or less a rational thinker. Arrange in the context of Europeans who came to India, arrange the following in the correct order of arrival: French, Portuguese, British and Dutch. Guys, do everybody know Mysore War? You guys have an idea of Mysore War? The first person to come to India was Portuguese. After Portuguese, the people who came to India were British. First person to come was Portuguese. Okay. Then British, then came Dutch, and eventually came French. Okay, the answer will be B. Arrange the following wars in chronological order. First, Anglo-Mysore War, Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar. Select the correct code. I mean the sequence. How did it happen? Okay. Battle of Plassey, which year? Battle of Buxar. Anglo-Mysore War 1767. Battle of Plassey was actually the first battle which made the British East India Company the actual rulers of Bengal. In the Battle of Plassey. In the Battle of Plassey, in fact, it was begun by Siraj-ud-Daula only. Siraj-ud-Daula became extremely angry about British misusing Dastak and also fortifying Calcutta. In return, Siraj-ud-Daula attacked Britishers in 1756. He captured Britishers, put them in jail. Some Britishers died. That event is called Black Hole Tragedy. In retaliation, in 1757, East India Company attacked Siraj-ud-Daula, and company was supported by Mir Jafar. The company had a decisive victory, and company made its presence in Bengal a permanent feature and a lasting feature. The battle itself took place in Plassey, which is today in Bengal Bihar region. The Battle of Buxar was a continuation of this. In Buxar in 1764, what happened is Mir Jafar himself was also removed by the Britishers, and they put his son-in-law Mir Qasim. The entire problem was, if you go through the textbook of modern India, you will understand the Britishers were misusing tax-free permits, which was affecting the Bengal economy. In return, the Britishers did not want to fall in line with the Bengal Nawab. Ye dispute mein hi in 1764, finally, whatever it is, the war became a big issue. Qasim killed the British region. Mir Qasim of Bengal, Shah Alam the Second of Mughals, and Shuja-ud-Daula of Awadh were together attacked by East India Company, where the company won over the war. In Battle of Plassey, company became the rulers of Bengal, but in the Battle of Buxar, which is a small town within the territory of Bengal, company became the ruler of India. The first Anglo-Mysore War was actually an Indian extension of the European War. Austrian War of Succession was happening in Europe. That war's Indian extension is Anglo-Mysore War. Anglo-Mysore War was not in reality Indian War. So these three wars are very, very important in our history. Next question. Consider the following about regarding the statements regarding drain of wealth theory. It was put forward by Dadabhai Nauroji. It was mentioned in the first time in the book, The Economic History of India and the Early British Rule. Which of the following statements is or are correct? Only one, only two, both one and two, none of the above. Rajshekhar, Nagadurga, where are you? Nagadurga, you there? Dadabhai Nauroji put forward in the drain of wealth theory in his book Poverty and Un-British Rule of India, not this book. He was actually the first guy to even use the word un-British. I mean, he created this word called un-British rule in India. So this option is correct, not this. Drain, Dadabhai Nauroji put forward his theory of drain of wealth in the book Poverty and Un-British Rule in India. Okay. The next question. He had given the name Brahmo Samaj to Brahmo Sabha. In 1839, he founded Tattva Bodhini Sabha to propagate Raja Ram Mohan Roy's ideas. He even led Adi Brahmo Samaj. With reference to this passage, I mean, who's it the passage referring to? Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Debendranath Tagore, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, Henry Vivian Derozio. Tattva Bodhini Sabha is your point of reference. Tattva Bodhini Sabha is actually an institution of Debendranath Tagore. Raja Ram Mohan Roy actually founded Brahmo Sabha in 1828. It was basically one of the first socio-religious reform institutions. He was well known for his abolishment of the practice of sati. Thanks to his efforts in 1829, Lord William Bentinck banned sati in Bengal. Raja even protested against East India Company's decision to support vernacular education and insisted that English must replace Sanskrit and Persian in India. Now, this is different to what your general perception is. Raja Ram Mohan Roy actually preferred English education over vernacular education. It was he who first introduced the word Hinduism in English language in 1816. Debendranath Tagore was a Hindu philosopher and later follower and friend of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He was one of the main founders of Brahmo Sabha or Brahmo religion, or the what we call Brahmoism. Brahmoism basically refers to anti-idol worship, anti-ritualism. His father was industrialist Dwarkanath Tagore. His movement Brahmo Samaj was formed in 1843 by merging Tattva Bodhini Sabha with Brahmo Sabha. He is very important leader in the Bengal Renaissance movement. Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, everybody knows, he is basically most popular for his widow remarriage movement. He received the title Vidya Sagar in Sanskrit, that is Ocean of Knowledge, from Sanskrit College, Calcutta. Vidya Sagar was well known, I mean, he was actually a DEO, educational officer, who worked very hard to give a stronger status to women and uplift women, particularly widows. He himself married a widow. Henry Vivian DeRosio mainly belongs to another movement called the Young Bengal Movement. DeRosio was actually in one way most radical of all the people present in that period. He criticized many of the social practices, many of the religious beliefs of Orthodox Hindus of that period, and he also was very instrumental in bringing, you can say, socio-religious reforms in Bengal. Quite a challenge. Each of these people are very, very important in your preparation. Next question, consider the following. Hunter Commission, Charles Wood's Dispatch, setting up of universities of Calcutta, Bombay and Madras, and Bethune College. This is an old prelims question. D. Bethune College is the first women's college to be established. That is Bethune College, uske baad Charles Wood's Dispatch, then comes your setting up of Calcutta, Bombay, Madras, and last Hunter Commission. Bethune College was founded by Bethune, is located in Calcutta, currently affiliated to University of Calcutta. Okay. Wood's Dispatch 1854, Hunter Commission 1842, 1849. This is after the 1853 Charter Act, no? What is Wood's Dispatch is basically considered, it's we call Wood's Dispatch the Magna Carta of English education in India. It's basically the first comprehensive plan made for spreading English education in India. I mean, see, this plan was actually based on the downward filtration theory. Under the downward filtration theory, the logic was, we will teach the masses and they will teach the people below them. So this entire system will go like this. We will teach the political or the upper classes, and the logic was the lower classes will be taught by the upper classes. It is basically a system of hierarchy from vernacular primary schools in villages at the bottom, followed by Anglo vernacular high schools and English schools at district level. Words dispatch, that's why we call it Magna Carta of English education, because it kind of created a model where people will start at vernacular language, then grow learning English to the top. It laid stress on female and vocational education. It recommended actually English as a medium of instruction for higher studies at vernaculars also and at school level. It recommended a system of grant in aids for private enterprise. This is what we call privatization of education also started here. I mean, you can run private schools, in return you will get some grant from government. Agriculture Institute at Pusa, Bihar, and an engineering institute at Roorkee, IIT Roorkee today, are actually from the Charles Woods dispatch model. Hunter Commission was also a commission established to analyze education system into India. I mean, how Woods dispatch is happening in India. There are two Hunter Commissions. One was the Jallianwala Bagh's Hunter Commission. The other is the Education Hunter Commission. Hunter Commission was established in order to analyze how the implementation of Woods dispatch has been happening. The commission was mainly appointed with the following aims, as I said, to understand, to inquire into the matter of effect of principles of dispatch of 1854, also to inquire into the position of primary education in India and suggest measures for its reforms, evaluate the work of missionaries in the field of education, to inquire government attitude towards private enterprise, and also establishing a commission to inquire into conditions of secondary education in India. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding Hindu Widow Remarriage Act. It was enacted in 1856 by Lord Dalhousie. It was enacted in response to the campaign by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. The law legalized the remarriage of Hindu widows as well as gave them right to inherit their deceased husband's property. Which of the following statements is or are correct? 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1 and 3, all of the above. C, 1 and 3. Who campaigned for widow remarriages? Was Rajaram? Was it Rajaram or was it Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar? And another thing, guys, whenever such questions come, remember, even by timeline also you can answer this. Rajaram was not even alive during 1856, no? Hindu Widow Remarriages Act was enacted by Lord Dalhousie. The law was enacted in response to the campaign by Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. The law legalized remarriage of Hindu widows as well as giving them right to inherit their deceased husband's property. This 1829 Sati Abolition Act and 1856 Widow Remarriage Act. Two most important radical social reforms of India. Yes, yes, yes. Match the following. Sindhia, Gaikwad, Bhosle, Holkar, Peshwa, Pune, Baroda, Nagpur, Gwalior and Indore. Select the correct code. Locations. Kingdom and the locations. Sindhias were of Gwalior. Gaikwad is in Baroda. Bhosle in Nagpur. Holkar in Indore. Peshwa, Pune. So the answer must be A. Let us see the next question, guys. The Governor General who followed the policy of doctrine of lapse was Just give me 1 second, guys. I'll just be back. Just give me the answer for this. Yeah, who followed Doctrine of Labs? Exactly. Everybody answered it. Good. Great. See, Dalhousie's Doctrine of Labs had two parts. Adopted son cannot be king. Simultaneously, prior permission must be taken for adoption. Like, for example, in this period, Mysore Nawab, Mysore King Wadayar could adopt a son. Whereas others could not. Couple of old multiple choice questions I'd like to discuss, which have come in history, art and culture period. Which of the following four Vedas contains an account of magical charms and spells? It was, this came in 2001 and 2004 UPSC prelims. Rigveda, Yajurveda, Atharva Veda and Samaveda. Magical charms and spells. Yes, the answer is C, Atharva Veda. Rig Veda is the mantra of, or the Veda of chanting, or what we can say, words or discipline. Yajur Veda is the Veda of ritual. Or you can say practice. Atharva Veda of magical spells and mantras. Sama Veda is of music. Music and mantras. Sorry, that answer is not correct. This is C. It is C. Atharva Veda. Which of the following statements is not correct? The statue of Gomateshwara at Shravanabelagola represents the last Tirthankara of Jains. India's largest Buddhist monastery is in Sikkim. Khajuraho temples were built under the Chandela kings. Hoysaleshwara temple is dedicated to Lord Shiva. Give me the answer. This was a question in prelims 2002. See, true. The question is specifically asking which of the following is not correct. In the not correct pattern, Gomateshwara is not the representation of last Tirthankara. The last Tirthankara is Vardhaman Mahavira. Gomateshwara is actually Bahubali, the son of Rishabhanada, first Tirthankara, right? Yes, Sandhya, you need to know most of the some of the common monasteries if they come in the newspaper. In 2002, Buddhist monastery was a newspaper. That's why it was current affairs part. Answer is A. Next question. Hoysala monuments are found in. This is a 2001 prelims question. Hampi and Hasperu region, Halebidu Belur region, Mysuru Bengaluru region, and Sringeri and Dharwad region. Yeah, yeah, Ramana, yes. Gomateshwara is the son of Rishabhadeva, no? I cover this part in my art and culture classes on Unacademy Plus. See, Unacademy Plus, I do teach art and culture. I'm going to start history optional in a week's time in Unacademy Plus. You can subscribe to the history optional. That way, it'll be helpful for you. It'll be kind of a four-month course. It'll be much easy. Belur Halebidu region. Here, the speciality of the Hoysala monuments or Hoysala temples are... They have a ground plan of star. Star pattern ground plan. See, general temples are like this, no? Panchayatana style. But Hoysala temples are like this. They are mainly seen in Beluru, Halebidu region. Next question. Which of the following animals was not represented on the seals and terracotta of Harappan culture given in 2001 UPSC prelims? A. Cow, B. Elephant, C. Rhinoceros, and D. Tiger. Yeah, the elephant is never visible. Sorry, cow is not their mainstream animal. I mean, cow may have existed, guys. I mean, there is a confusion in this question. Never say cow did not exist, because that cannot be concluded. There was a bull, cow will be there. The thing is, cow was probably not their forte or not their main identifying animal. Next question. Which of the following pairs is correctly matched? Harappan civilization painted graveware, Kushana's Gandhara school of art, Mughals Ajanta painting, and Marathas Pahadi school of paintings. 2002 UPSC prelims question. Yes, their question is asking correctly matched. 2002 Kushanas, Gandhara School of Art. Harappans is red and black pottery ware. Mughals are known for Mughal paintings. Ajanta is basically Gupta paintings, Mughal miniature paintings. Pahadi school is mainly seen in the Himachal region, Jammu, Himachal. Marathas, Maharaja Serfoji promoted Tanjavur style, no? I refer these in my art and culture classes. Red and black pottery ware is Harappan. It's actually B. Kushanas. Kushanas, Kushanas. Who among the following presided over the Buddhist council held during the reign of Kanishka at Kashmir in 2005 prelims question? Parshava, Shudraka, Nagarjuna and Vasumitra. Kundalavana, Kashmir. The sponsor was Kanishka. And the guru was Vasumitra and later Aswaghosha. Aswaghosha. Okay. Guys, keep watching my profile, my Unacademy profile. This entire month I'll be doing MCQ series. In fact, from now on we'll be doing more MCQs. Even on Unacademy I'll be running free classes of multiple choice questions. To get the main idea of this set is to get you used to recollecting an answer. Always remember, the trick in prelims is not remembering everything but training yourself to recollect what you know. The reality is you all have read through, you all know the answer. You just need to know how to recollect an answer, and that recollection technique will come as and when you do more practice. Keep watching my profile. Unacademy subscription also is quite helpful for you. You can use my code ShrivanR to get an extra 10% discount, but obviously it'll really help you with both your GS as well as optional guidance, and it's a 1 year guidance anyway. The rest is up to you, but I'll be running Unacademy free sessions, which doesn't need any you to pay anything, free lessons on Unacademy Plus. Do also follow me on my Facebook, where I do put the details of all my courses. facebook.com/SrivanR, or you can search me as Nathan Vikas Kondala on Facebook. So on my Facebook profile, this is my Telegram number, or WhatsApp number 9985511391. You can ping me anytime. If you need anything, I'll help you out. Thank you for your time. Keep following. I will see you the next time.